that has given me privilege to stand before the people of God this night. And I'm so happy to be in your workers' meeting, because this is workers' meeting and workers' service. I'm discussing with your pastor now, and by God's grace, we will discuss some little things before we round up tonight.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Father, I want to appreciate you. Thank you for saving us. Thank you for salvation of our souls. Thank you for giving us privilege to serve you. Thank you for choosing us as a workers in your vineyard. It's a privilege to be a workers in your vineyard. Oh, we appreciate this, Lord. Father, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Thank you for this parish. Thank you for the leader you have chosen for them in this parish. Like pastors, like the workers. We appreciate you for your son. Thank you for using him in this parish. Thank you for big things you have done. Thank you for what you are doing now. Thank you for what you are going to do. We appreciate you for tonight. We give you praise. We give you adoration. Lord, accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are your presence this night. What you alone can do in our lives, do it tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In this worker service, surprise us with miracles in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Abundant blessing. Let it be our own portion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And then tonight, let your name alone be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you for hearing us, God. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
I want to hear your amen loud and clear.
Amen.
Shout a powerful hallelujah. Shall we be seated, please? Greeting from our daddy and Lord, the general overseer of this church, Daddy E. Adeboye. I'm so glad to be in your midst this night. I want to appreciate your pastor that given us this privilege to stand before the people of God. We are in the workers' meeting. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Oh, I call it workers' service. And I now ask, why workers' meeting? Why workers' service? What is the meaning of workers' meeting in the Redeemed Christian Church of God? What we meant on the church as a workers is to prepare for service, for Sunday service. And they thought of them that once you join the workers in this church, you are one of the pillars of the church. Because all the responsibility of the church is upon the workers. By the time we join the church, we eager to now become workers. Because workers in Redeem, they are the people that do all the work on Sunday. And that is where you join. When you join that group, you are one of the workers. Only God, only heaven can limit your promotion in the church once you become a worker. That is foundation of every position in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. Daddy Gio, when he came to the church, passed through workers in training and joined worker. And from the workers now, gradually grow, till you get to where he was today. And every one of us, we joined the church, just come, we came to the church, and
had fellowship after our salvation. We said we want to join the workers and we become a workers, and now they begin to train us. The day that they gave us letter to become a deacon, we rejected it. Why? I told them that time that there's nobody in my generation to become pastor. I'm not coming to this church to become pastor or deacon or whatever. I'm just in the church to serve God, do the work of God, and make it to heaven. But our pastor then said, because you perform very well, that is why they choose you. They see your honesty, they see your faithfulness, they see your obedience, everything that it requires in the Bible. That is what they saw in your life. That is why they choose you as deacon. We are the first set of deacon of the Abigail. Our pastor begged us before we collected that letter. We don't know that the more they promote you in this church, the more they committed you into the work. We don't know. And I'm saying to you now, if you are looking for a position in this church, just keep on doing the work of God. When you are doing the work, whatever position that God thinks you fit for, He will take you there. That is God. As we collected that letters of deacon, we went to confession and we were ordained. Immediately we back from confession, my pastor now called me and said, we have established one small parish. I said, yes, sir. He said, you are the one we will send to that parish. I said, no, sir. It's not possible. He said, that is why they ordained you. I said, I was not told. If I know that you want to send me out to become a pastor, I won't get that ordination. He said, ordination is to walk. It's not done to serve table, as he laid down in the Bible. He said, in this church, once they ordain you, you now go and lead people too. As a pastor. They said, you are now a pastor of a parish. And my pastor prayed for me. And he sent me. And I have my boss there. The village is very far to the town. I said, where to that place? Who will be buying it? They said, you are the one. I said, church will not give me money. Dude. Which church? They said, there's no member in the place now. You are the one who will go and start the work. And God will go with you. And I went. Here I am today. By the special grace of God, I have got to the position of national elders in this church. And without appointment or whatever, that's the last position in the regime. Once you become a national elder, the only remaining thing is appointment. If you become AQ, SA, regional, evangelist, is appointment. It's not promotion. Once you are workers in this church, I want to tell you the fact that months, no one can limit your promotion. That is why, if anybody said it's a worker in the redeemed presence of God, you are ambassador of Christ. I'm discussing with your pastor now. I said, any place that I want to fellowship with them in redeemed, if I don't go to their workers' meeting, fellowship in their workers' meeting, I can't access that church. And when I heard that you are doing your workers' meeting on Saturday, I said, one Saturday, I told your pastor, I said, I want to be in a workers' meeting.
I want to assess this church.
Your pastor asked me, I said, I want to start everything with you here today. As you are doing it, that is, I want to be with you. And before my arrival, they have read the open heaven. I asked pastor, I said, she didn't say they will wait. That we start the church. They have started it. And now ask me, are we to repeat it on Monday? No. It's not it. I've had that one. But I want to appreciate and I want to congratulate you. Being a workers in this church, faithful workers, honest workers, believe honestly, is a passport to heaven for you. And we all make it to heaven in Jesus' name. I told the pastor now, I said, to assess the workers, parish, determined by pastor. Once the pastor is accessible, there's no other problem again. Because like pastors, like the workers. And that is the problem we have in the church today, leadership problem. People will say, by six, we must meet in the church, and the leader now will come to the church quarter after six. And now be giving excuse. On my way, I brought a so-so-so place. I saw so-so-so. No. There's no excuse that can you. Once you say six, we should be in the church. Whatever may cause, you must be in the church by before six as a leader. And that is what we call leadership. That's what I told the pastor. I said, you are the one will determine of what will happen in this church. God is doing his own, but you must first of all play your own part before God do his own. And I thank God, and I want to appreciate God for the life of your pastor. Amen. If you are clapping for God, for Jesus, concerning him, clap it very well. Leader is the one who determine the congregation. Leader is the one determine the workers. Let me tell you, they said you are doing four services here on Sunday. It is through you people. And because he decided, he wanted, he prayed for it, God granted it for him. And you people supported him. If not so, it will be work. That is the truth of the matter. Once the leader said, this is where we are going, and he been a good example for what they have said, other will follow. That is what Jesus Christ did. And that is what disciples did after Jesus left in Acts. When they see the Christian, the people following Jesus, they said these people are exactly like Christ. They are doing exactly like him. Whatever he said, that is what he's doing. And workers in this church must be faithful, honest, obedient completely. If they say stand up, you stand, sit down, you sit down. Do this, no question. Why do I need to stand? Why are you sending me to that place? You are not unable workers. Anywhere they send you to, and you go. It is not the one who sent you that you respect. Whom do you respect? Oh. It's God in his life. If you are able workers, rise on your feet and shout the powerful hallelujah. Shall we be seated, please? Now, it's not the pastor that you are respecting. God has sent him. It's not because pastor knows how to do anything. Nobody knows how to do anything. It is God's grace upon our lives, everybody. Nobody is perfect. I told the pastor now. I said in this church now, the one that they can be in the front, that and I will queue at the back and stand by him in the church is Daddy Joe.
people we stand by ourselves. I won't stay at their back. If they say we are going. If they say they can't go, I go my way. But the one that I will stand on his back, going and follow, is him. Why? There's nothing that they will preach that will not put it into practice. And that's Christ-like. That's leadership we need. And that is the type of leadership that is leading you. If anybody preach anything, if your pastor said we are going to this whole time here, and now said, sorry, oh, my wife cannot be here. I'll be the only one that will be here. Once he said that to one, all the remaining women that are in the church, if they left to that workers' meeting, he has no mouth to discipline anybody. Because once I've accepted excuse for his own wife, likewise the same woman, they are the same now. But once you say nobody should late, and I don't late with my wife, if you late to the workers' meeting, you are in trouble. Because that is our agreement. And that is what we call workers. In this Lagos Prophet 3, I've been to a Sona headquarter. My contact was 7, and I was told that workers' meeting started by 7. And I got there. Even I missed road. I want to be there by 6:30. But I missed road. I got there by 6:45. I look at my watch. Nobody in the church except the security. And I had the security. Did your people come to church today? They said they are coming. Okay? 10 minutes to 7. I said they are coming. They said they are coming. Okay? 5 minutes to 7. Is workers coming to the meeting? They said they are coming that day. Okay, let's wait and see. I said 7 sharp. Close the door. The door at the back, close it. Close everything. I stayed at the door and I will stay with you. Nobody should enter. And 7 sharp, nobody. I said, close the door. And the door was closed. And one sister, a minute after service, she came, I said, sit outside. Only one person. 5 minutes after service, the parish pastor came with his wife. And when they saw the security, they said, I want to enter. I said, enter where? You didn't see me? I said, I'm the one that said he should close the door. He said, yeah, if you know where I'm coming, you will pity me. I said, from where are you coming, sir? He said, from Badagri here, road here, to First Park here. I said, when do you leave home this morning? He said, just 6 or 5 after 6. I said, I left camp by 5:30. Tell me another story, sir. I said, out! Please, stay. And other people, they are joining him. Join. Now, the solar pastor now came around 12 after 7 with his wife. And when he saw everybody outside, there's fire on the mountain. And the wife said, Daddy, please. I said, don't please, ma'am. All of you leave. We are going to Victory House for fellowship today. There will be no service here today. If that is the way we are doing it, workers on Sunday. The wife begins to beg. Now I said, okay. After some minutes, I considered, I said, let us enter. And I told her, I said, let this one be the first and the last. Workers in redeem. When they said the church has fallen, there's no church again. It is we spoil it. It is leader. Once the leader is ready, the followers will do what? They'll be ready with him. When your pastor said you should be here before 6 now, and your pastor is already here, how many of you are here now? Is anyone late to the workers' meeting? Is any late comer? Even there is, they'll be very few. Once your pastor is around, And if anybody late to the work hospital, it should be discipline. That's what they taught us in this church. And that is what we follow. I want to tell you tonight, you have not made a mistake, yo. To be in the representative of God, I said you have not done? You have not made a mistake. I keep on praising God every day, directing my feet to this church. Because no one invites me. My wife does a belief in the secondary school, become a believer. And when we marry, we are looking for where the fellowship, and we just saw this church. They call it church Elepuma, that where they are crying, weeping, redeemed. Because in the church, that time they didn't pray, it's weeping. When we get to say, oh God, oh mercy. I thought they are doing then, 70s. Cry! And we enter there. And we saw them the way they cry for their sin. We like it. I said, this is a church. And that was how we joined. Nobody invited us. But my pastor, as I stepped to that church, oh, visitation, visitation. Visited me. I said, pastor, don't come to my house again. I said, yes, sir. I said, one day we'll come. Until I is saved. My pastor keep on visiting me. The day I say, he said, God has arrested you now. We have to go again. I am the one who will go to pastor that let us go and visit people again. He said, do you see it now, Brother James? Let me tell you, once you are a workers in this church, able and workers in deed, you have not made a mistake. God can take you to any length of life on this earth. And by doing that, by occupying doing that work, it will be very difficult for you to be dwelling in sin. The work of God, they allow people to commit sin. That's the purpose of workers. A faithful workers. Since people see you as a faithful worker, they will be calling you pastor. Immediately I say, join the workers, in where I'm working then, immediately they call me pastor. Because my life do what?
Change.
My manager there in the cooperative, he said, hey, are we? As you are going, you become a pastor. I said, I'm a pastor already. He said, I will wait, watch you for 5 years. If you are still boiling for Christ like this, you become a pastor in function. After 5 years, I went to my boss and I said, okay, I'm still continuing. He said, you can't work with us again. You better go and join pastor. And that is how I resigned. I said, I can't cope with you again. Let me tell you, if you get newly born again, being a worker in this church, join and faithful workers, you are more than many, many, many pastors in some nations. Except you are not faithful. Because of being a worker in this church, you must totally committed. Since for 30 years ago now, I never led to workers meeting till today. Many parishes in Lagos Province, three now, I've been in their parish, I've visited them, I will go to the church before the pastor. Because they said we are going to meet by 7, I'll be there by 6:30. And I'm leaving at camp. If not because I want to attend this workers meeting today, if they said I will preach here 6:30 tomorrow, I will make sure I will get here 6:15 from the camp. And that is grace of God. Once you surrender your life to God, God is there for you to help you. That's the truth of the matter. Your first thing is to surrender. The grace now to be the doer is in the hands of God. And He will give it to you. That's our God. I will just talk briefly now. I think time has gone. Time has gone over. Let me just mention this in our doctrine. I'll mention a place for you that very crucial to the workers. And that is lesson 14. We believe in the church about restitution. What do I say?
Restitution.
What is restitution? Restitution is a mark of true repentance. If we are genuinely saved, if truly God has changed your life, whatever bad thing that you have done before that doesn't give you rest of mind, you must restitute it. Because after your salvation, your spirit now, your inner mind, will be now telling you some things that have not passed. That you call yourself a Christian? Are you truly a Christian? Once that person is saying that one to you, it's reminding you that you must do the restitution of it. Because if you don't do the restitution, when the trumpet sound, as we have read in our open level of tomorrow, have you not been so? You won't hear the sound. That spirit will not allow you. It will knock your ear. It will not allow you to hear. And once you don't hear, you can't go. If you don't go, and you want to go, you now will buy that salvation by your own personal blood, not the blood of Jesus again. You will now redeem yourself by yourself. And how are you going to do that one? Whatever tribulation, whatever problem come that time, you accepted it. If they said they will cut your hand, once you call the name of Jesus Christ, you say, yeah, I'm okay. Cut it. I'm going with Jesus. They said they plug your eyes, you said, plug it. I'm going with Jesus. They said they will put your hand on fire, you said, put it there. I'm going with Jesus. Once you do that one, you now redeemed yourself by your own blood. How many people can do that? Anything that don't give you rest of mind, you must do the restitution. Write it down, Exodus 22, 1 to 3. Leviticus 6, 1 to 7. Why restitution? Restitution is necessary because of law of harvest. Whatever you sow, you will do what?
You reap.
If you say you are saved and you have done wicked things before and you did not restitute it, they will still pay you before you leave this earth. But once you are saved and you do the restitution, the blood of Jesus will wipe everything away. Why restitution? To make it so that it make it so that to have a clean conscience before God and man. You can find that one in Acts chapter 24, verse 16. Write it down. So that your conscience will be very clear. That's why we do restitution. Anything that doesn't give you rest of mind, you want to pray, it will come to your mind. You want to do anything, come to your mind. You need to do the restitution. And please, if you want to do the restitution, it's not just something you don't decide. Number three things why you should do restitution: to make it to heaven. Anybody that has anything that is troubling your mind, when trumpet sound, that thing will not allow you to go. But once you do the restitution, it's clear. That is why it's very, very compulsory. And type of restitution. Wrong marriage. You can do the restitution. Stolen item. You can do the restitution. Human relation. Someone that said, I will never greet you again. For any reason, and you call yourself a Christian, you better go and do the restitution. If that one didn't greet you, go and meet him or her. I am greeting you, please. Even if it's the one offended you, go and beg him or her. Why? Because of what? Because of heaven. No, sir. He has offended me. And both of you will not go. That is why you need to go and beg the person so that he agree with you. If he doesn't greet you before, once you beg, you now begin to beg him or beg her. Stolen some item, whatever thing before your salvation that doesn't give you rest of mind, that some things you stole that after salvation has forgiven, God has forgiven you, God has wiped you. But the one that's coming to your mind every time, that is Holy Spirit. Do the restitution. And you see the word of God in Malachi chapter 3, verse 8 to 10. What is there? Luke chapter 9, verse 8. In Malachi chapter 3, verse 8 to 10. If I have not a title before, and your mind, you don't have rest of mind on it, you better do the restitution. If you can't pay all what you hold, because what you hold before, if you decided that I will pay the 6 months you want to pay, and as from now, I will never owe God my tithe again. You pay that 6 months with interest of 20% of your tithe. Very, very compulsory. Restitution for workers is very, very important. And once you do that, you have the rest of mind to serve God, have rest of mind to pray. And once you do that, you are free. Restitution is very, very important for every children of God. That's what we believe in the church. My time is very short. And I will stop from that place now. Your prayer you are going to pray now is prayer of grace to faithful unto God completely. Shall we rise on our feet now? You will now say, Father, be grace to faithful unto you. Upon my life now. Talk to the Almighty God now. Talk to God now. The grace, you cannot run this way by yourself. You don't have enough power. The energy is not there. The strength is not there. But once the grace of God come upon your life, it's so easy for you. Talk to the Almighty God this night. Give me the grace, Lord. Pray. Talk to God.